Romeo, when you approached your house, what were your first thoughts?
My thoughts definitely weren't to save anything anymore now. I just wanted to make sure everyone was safe also in the area and clear out anybody who could be saved. Right now, I've been camping out at our factory where we managed just before the floods came in to build some brick walls. And we have about 40 pumps running 24 hours a day. So I'm camping out here with some workers and friends trying to save the only thing that's left for us now, which is our factory. And we have some production lines inside. So if we can save those, we can start again.
And Romeo, what kind of factory is it? And what kind of factory is it that is there in northern Bangkok? And what's the situation exactly there?
Well, what we make, we produce plastic, and the situation here is dramatic. There is no access to this area without boat. The first couple of days, they had military trucks, but now those have gotten stuck as well. So they're along the roads and not moved. So the only way is by boat. So I have some friends who helped me out. Particularly Alex Stamp, I want to say his name because he really helped me out a lot. We're just holding out. But there's a lot of people who the only way they move around is they have some foam rafts. So entire families, and they're still stuck up here. I'm really confused at how in Bangkok everything is going on still as normal. We're just a few kilometers north of Bangkok, and we have 2 meters of water here.
It's such a contrast. It really is, Romeo, because the northern and eastern parts of Bangkok are inundated, but then the central business district is fairly dry. We're looking at live pictures here. Now, Romeo, we are showing video on our air of that you shot and you gave us permission to air.
Yes.
It's quite dramatic. Can you walk us through some of the things you saw? And right now we're looking at one of your friends putting the paddle into the water. He puts it in backwards, and the entire shaft of the paddle is just swallowed up by water, which shows us how high this is. Tell us where you were
That's right.
when you shot this video.
It's all around this area that we've been going. My main concern was to save my family at first, and I had to bring them out. I have a wife and 2 kids, so I had to bring them out by boat. They've gone out of Bangkok, and I am basically here trying to save whatever's left of our factory. What we've seen the last couple of days are some surreal scenes where everyone is trying to escape this ordeal as best they can. We saved a handicapped lady who couldn't walk, and so we went in and we got in with the boat just barely under her garage without hitting our heads. And so we got her to safety where it's a little bit drier and the military trucks can take them out. We try to pick up as many people as we can, but there aren't that many boats around this area. And one thing that, I'd like to say now that, I'm on air is we need water. Drinking water in this area is like gold now. It can't be found, and so drinking water, food supplies, these kind of basic necessities are missing right now.
That's a good point, Romeo. How are people getting supplies? And you had mentioned that you had to evacuate your house, and we have video of that because your house is flooded. So you're staying at your own factory. How are you and how are your employees getting clean drinking water and getting food?
Well, we're doing that through friends who lower them down from there's a tollway, and they lower them down with rope onto a boat that we managed to get, and so we're managing to get supplies in this way. The main roads right now are like very strong rivers. There's a really strong current going in Bangkok direction actually, and so it's impossible without a motor boat. Unless you have a motor boat, you can't imagine to go. It's impossible to go upstream. Even with a small motor boat, it's difficult. So you need quite a large motor boat to be able to go upstream. So the other day we met a five days old baby and his mother on a little paddle boat trying to go upstream.
Amazing.
So we pulled them to the place they wanted to go, but it's just crazy what's going on, you know. One thing that all the Thais around here, they're taking it with a smile, you know. They're all fighting through this, and you know how Thai people are very strong at heart, and no one's giving up here.
And we're hearing stories about neighbors helping neighbors. Romy, I do want to ask you about the five-day holiday that the government has instituted, and the government did that because it was trying to encourage residents to leave Bangkok. And I realize we're talking about a city of 12 million people, but are you getting a sense of why people have chosen to stay behind when the government is telling them to leave Bangkok?
You know, honestly, I've been in this situation for 8 days now. 8 days. So I'm not really sure about what's going on with what the government has done. I have no access to television or anything like that, you know. We're camping out a little bit and living almost like animals here. So I'm not really sure of what else is going on around. I can tell you what's going on here, you know. What is the impression I'm getting is that to save central Bangkok, they have somehow sent all the water in this direction, which we didn't expect to get this high. You know, in my residential area, you know, everyone was thinking we were going to make it, no problems. I had boats. I was the first to have boats because my factory went under, and I was bringing boats back to my front yard, and people were kind of laughing. Hey, what do you need a boat for? And now there's 2 meters of water there. So I'm just wondering where all this water is going to go. It's got to go somewhere, right? So, I'm not going to comment on the government or what they're doing, and because I don't know. And I haven't been informed as well. No one knows how much more water is coming. It's been rising for 8 days now, no stop. So, you know, I'd like that information, actually. What are we supposed to do? How much more water is? How much longer do we have to hold on here? Some people say 1 week, some people say a couple months. So, you know, it's a pretty scary situation. The only way I can keep this factory dry, not dry is a big word, you know, with shallow water inside and save the production lines is with petrol to those pumps, those water pumps. Mm.